1976, London, England, 12th round action. World welterweight crown at stake, and there, Carlos Palomino, the underdog, giving it to Stracy, flooring him twice. Stracy could go no further. Palomino became the champion. 3 months earlier, March 76, San Juan, Puerto Rico, a 17-year-old kid in white trunks named Wilfredo Benitez giving a boxing lesson to the world junior welterweight champion Antonio Cervantes. Benitez, in a thrilling upset, won it. He became the world junior welterweight champion. Now, today, on ABC's International Championship Boxing Series premiere from Hiram Bighorn Stadium in San Juan, Puerto Rico, the WBC World Welterweight Championship fight between Carlos Palomino, the champion, and the still unbeaten number one welterweight contender, young Wilfredo Benitez. ABC Sports presents... the premiere of ABC's International Championship Boxing. This ABC Sports exclusive is brought to you by Rise, with three softeners for a quick, close shave. And by Selectivision, the four-hour video cassette recorder from RCA. You're looking at part of the assembled crowd, and it is a very big one indeed at Hiram Bighorn, or if you prefer, Bighorn Stadium in San Juan, Puerto Rico. They're here for the WBC World Welterweight Championship fight, Carlos Palomino against Wilfredo Benitez. Hello again, everyone. Welcome to San Juan, Puerto Rico. A blistering sun, 87 degrees, a hot, sultry breeze. Puerto Rican weather, in other words. And today marks the debut of ABC's new International Championship Boxing Series. We're proud of this series because we think today's bout, the first title bout of this calendar year, bespeaks the quality that you'll be seeing in boxing. And at both the amateur and professional levels. Examples: 2 weeks hence, the United States against the Soviet Union, amateurs. 2 weeks after that, the United States against Cuba, a live telecast from Havana, Cuba. Later, the U.S. against Poland. And other professional championship fights like February 18th, an action-packed rematch between Marvin Johnson and Matt Franklin, light heavyweight title at stake. Right now, the World Welterweight Championship at stake, so let's get down to business. Wilfredo Benitez, only 20, heralded constantly by the boxing writers of America, has been stylish, but some feel has lacked substance. Let's find out more about him as we review his boxing career through a brief history we've prepared and look at his strengths, his vulnerabilities, and his style. Wilfredo Benitez, right there in the dark trunks, is unquestionably a skilled boxer, but with a vulnerability. And this is first title defense against Emiliano Villas, outlaw from Colombia. He won easily, later became a full-fledged welterweight. The vulnerability first showed itself against another unbeaten fighter, Bruce Curry, in the Garden in New York in November of 77. Right there, the vulnerability, the chin to the left hook. But Benitez came on to win a split decision. In his second fight, Benitez showed that he had the quality of learning ability, because here he stayed away from that left hook and won a clean-cut decision against Curry. And against Randy Shields, he showed he had some power, too. This action in the sixth round in the Garden in August of 78, Shields didn't come out for the seventh. Finally, the old vulnerability reasserted itself in December of 78 against Vernon Lewis, right there. The uppercut did him in. So he is a boxer, but problems remain.
Wilfredo survived that near knockdown from the uppercut, of course, and won the decision over Vernon Lewis. Now, what about the opponent? The unexpected winner of the welterweight crown on June 22nd, 1976 in London, England, over John Stracy. Carlos Palomino. What about his style? What about his vulnerabilities? He's 29 years of age now. Let's review quickly the career of Carlos Palomino in glossary form so that you folks at home can learn more about him. The storyline on Carlos Palomino is that he is a great finisher, comes on strongly in the late rounds, but may be troubled by a clever boxer. Here his first title defense against Munoz, he came on to win it, as you see. And then against Davey Boy Green in June of 77 in London, in round 11, because Green had given him a great deal of trouble in the early rounds, he knocked Green out cold right there. But this fellow, Everaldo Azevedo, fights a little bit perhaps like Benitez. Clever, stayed away from Palomino and gave him some trouble, though Palomino won. And then Palomino fought three mediocre opponents in a row. This was one of them. Ryu Soramachi won them all easily. Finally, in his last title defense against his old friend Mundo Muniz, Muniz again excelled in the early rounds, but in the late going, it was all Palomino and he won. Let's meet Carlos up close and personal. Palomino is a rags-to-riches story, owns expensive sports cars, has more than $1 million worth of real estate, and drives a car with a license plate that says 15 round. Not your ordinary man, and outside of the ring, not like many of your ordinary fighters. Listen.
My father's been a boxing fan for years, and he's told me stories of the fighters who have made all the money and ended up with nothing. And when I got into boxing, I decided that's not going to happen to me. I want an ace in the hole. If my career as a professional boxer doesn't work out to what I think and I believe it might happen, I want to be able to come back and have something to fall back on. I want a career in education. Right now, I'm taking some acting lessons. I'd like to give acting a try. I'm very serious about it. I've done a couple of things on, I've done a couple of appearances on talk shows, and I've done a special guest appearance on a series, Taxi.
I want a dirty trick, building me up like that. And I'm gonna teach this guy a lesson.
I wanna get one for free.
I want to be able to be an actor, a good actor, not just because I'm a fighter and I'm going to do boxing episodes. I want to be able to go out and play different roles and be good at it.
Crazy Tony, yeah!
So you can see that Carlos is laying a foundation for his future when he gives up boxing. And whenever he gets a break in his fight training, he trains for what he hopes will be an acting career by visiting Hollywood locations like this one for the upcoming comedy titled The Main Event, starring that lady, Barbara Streisand, and Ryan O'Neill as a fighter. Barbara, of course, in the picture, is his manager. And Carlos intently observes and sometimes talks to Ryan.
Take a look at his eye. You see his eye? How he's up here.
Yeah. Carlos did this to me in training.
Actually, I did it to him. We had a fight yesterday.
Anyway, you won, dear.
Yes, thank you.
We're back live at ringside. You're looking at Carlos Palomino, the defending world welterweight champion, WBC version. He's 29 years of age. Two questions about him in this fight. The heat, 87 degrees, the hostility of the crowd. Benitez, though born in the Bronx, grew up in Puerto Rico, lives here in Justine, Puerto Rico. Palomino, as you look at Benitez right there, Palomino, Mexican-born, but at age 10, came to live in California and now resides in Westminster, California. We're almost ready for the opening bell. Scoring on the 10-point must system, three knockdown rule waived, no saving by the bell, mandatory 8-count, 8-ounce gloves, ring size 21 feet, figures to favor Benitez. The bell for round one. The third man in the ring, the veteran referee Jay Edson, the judges Zach Clayton and Harry Gibbs. More on them later. Remember, Palomino to the left of your screen in the dark trunks. Green if you've got color, dark if you're in black and white. Usually a slow starter. Benitez, a clever style boxer, uses the head to slip punches very well, therefore doesn't need to use the feet as much as one might think. Right there, led, Benitez did with a left and right. Tremendous puncher to the midsection is Palomino, at least that's been his history. This is first round action. Fighters wary at this point. Benitez, an excellent counter puncher. But off the blows he took from Curry and from Vernon Lewis, suspect in the minds of some. And then he is so young. He fought to a draw with Harold Weston back in February of 77 in some field. But that was evidence that he's a showboat. He was well ahead and then coasted and almost lost the fight. You'll hear the crowd roar every time Benitez throws a punch. You'll probably hear silence when Palomino does. Little action thus far in the round. Benitez pecking cautiously. Palomino on the inside, after missing with the right, trying to come up with the left uppercut. Almost at the 2-minute mark of round one. Feeling each other out, everything very wary, very cautious. Trying to score points with the left. You saw how quick the hands are. This is a youngster with hand speed. That's the way he did away with Cervantes with that left jab to win the World Junior Welterweight title when he was only 17. Left to the head and then a quick, he doubled up on it to the belly. We are approaching, as you can see in the low right-hand corner of your screen, the end of round one.
I'll be wearing a...
Back, the start of round two. Palomino is back to you. Benitez in the white trunks. Benitez's face registering a determination. He may be the type of athlete who can rise to the occasion, who does just enough to win against lesser opponents. We'll find out something about that today, I trust. Notice the way Palomino there went to the belly. This is his strong point. That's the way he beat Stracy into submission. Though not raised and trained in Mexico, he possesses the classic weapon of great Mexican fighters, the left hook to the liver. It debilitates the opponent. Palomino feels the heat won't hurt him because he's been down here since December 28th. The crowd roared, but Benitez did not connect. And he feels in the time he's been here, he's acclimated himself to the heat. Second round action. On the other side of the coin, some feel they detect in Palomino a lessening in interest. He's got good money there. Benitez connected there with a right. He's got a record purse for this division coming to him today, $450,000. And he still hopes to become a movie actor, as we showed you in his up close and personal. We're a minute 50 seconds into round two. So far, Benitez boxing smartly, giving Palomino few opportunities. This is the debut of our International Championship Boxing Series, WBC welterweight crown at stake. The crowd yelling again as Benitez went to the stomach and then up. They will yell at every turn for Wilfredo, whose real name is Wilfred, but they insist on calling him Wilfredo. There is up till now clearly goes to Benitez on grounds of boxing. The end of the round at hand. We're back at ringside, San Juan, Puerto Rico, the start of round three. Benitez to the left of your screen, and now Palomino to the left. The first two rounds, Benitez fighting cautiously, much in the manner he did against Antonio Cervantes. Not being hit, a good right there by Benitez, not being hit by Palomino. What you have to remember about Palomino is he's a very slow starter and a very strong finisher. That's been his history. Let's see if he still has that ability today. Mando Muniz, first fight against Palomino for the title, had Palomino down. First round, Palomino came on to win. There you saw Benitez counterpunching effectively. He is not known as a slugger, though. Right there, Palomino trying to go to the belly, then up to the head with the left. Benitez pecking away with that left jab. Low being picked off twice in a row by Palomino's gloves. Sun pouring onto the ring, making it hard for some ringsiders to even see the action. Ryan O'Neill, the movie actor, Palomino's friend, is here at ringside. Right there you saw Benitez with a left and right. The left did not get through. The right only grazed. The left again. Point is, though, Benitez is carrying the action. The crowd roared as a left grazed Palomino. Good left to the chest by Benitez. A counterpunch following a Palomino lead. Benitez is a remark. An excellent counterpuncher. Fighting astutely. No showboating today. Too much at stake. Sitting right behind us is Tommy Hearns, the young unbeaten welterweight who knocks out just about everybody. Some equate him in ability with Sugar Ray Leonard. Thus far, Benitez dominating with the left, keeping Palomino off balance. Palomino not able to get into him. We're at the 2:45 mark of this, the third round. Coming up to the end of round three, Benitez looking good. Ringside, San Juan, Puerto Rico, round four underway. Benitez quickly looking more confident now. The first three rounds, he's used his left effectively to score and to keep Palomino away. Carlos has not yet been able to get inside where he can devastate an opponent. Crowd oohs and ahs with every Benitez flicking jab. Left missed to the head, but got into the tummy by Benitez. See the way Benitez keeps moving that head. Keeps scarring with the left. And in his native land here, not one to say that the officials can be intimidated, but anything is possible in the event of a close bout. September of 70. Oh, Palomino scored with a right there. And a left, Palomino. Got to remember that Palomino still got the fighting spirit, and if his hands aren't brittle, this is a sturdy man. That left to the belly by Palomino. That's what Benitez has to be concerned about. Palomino is now scoring better. We're a minute 45 into the round, and for the last minute, Palomino has been doing his best work of this late afternoon on the island of Puerto Rico. Edson's splitting them. perhaps a mild warning to Palomino. There's a good left and right combination by Palomino. Carlos definitely coming on in this round. Two quick jabbing lefts by Benitez. Good right landed by Palomino. Benitez fighting back on the inside. We're at 2 minutes and 30 into this, the fourth round. Crowd roaring as Benitez shows it fighting and comes fighting back. But on balance, oh, that did not score. Forget the crowd on that. That left got in. Palomino picking blows off. On balance, not a bad round for Palomino. For round five. In the fourth round, Palomino started to come on some, though Benitez excelled in the last 40 seconds of the round. So on balance, in my view, that round was even. I gave Benitez the first three rounds. This is round five. In Benitez's corner, an old familiar face, Emil Griffith, trainer, past welter and middleweight champion of the world. Crowd roared, as they will, with every blow thrown by Wilfredo, whether it scores or not. There is no question, however, that the quickness of Benitez has been extremely important to his effectiveness thus far. Much quicker with the hands, quicker with the feet. There is foot movement, as you can see. And then he's slippery with the head and movement of the shoulders. Right there. That was a good and interesting exchange. Because as Palomino sought to go to the belly, A, he did not get through cleanly, and Benitez, unafraid, came right back and scored against Palomino. This is the best, up till now, I have ever seen Benitez look. Palomino with a right lead to the stomach. Clearly, he's going to keep going to the body, as has always been his wont. We're a minute 50 into the fifth round. Benitez continues. Fox beautiful. Oh, he was hit by that Palomino left and he felt it. The head snapped back. Flashiness of Benitez can be very impressive to a lot of officials scoring a fight. Saw Palomino, you worked that left to the midriff again. Wants to wear Benitez down. Fifth round action. A right and a strong left by Palomino. And Benitez felt it. Now we're approaching the end of the round with Palomino coming alive. This was Palomino scoring with the right and left, and it hurt Benitez. I gave Palomino the fifth round. Now we're in the sixth round, live from Irem Bithorn or Bithorn Stadium in San Juan, Puerto Rico. Watch Palomino closely now to see if he, at 29 and perhaps somewhat rusty, hasn't fought since last May. He had suffered a broken left hand in his last fight against Muniz. Let's see if he can come on in his accustomed way. Quickness still in that jab of Benitez, as you can see. Benitez scored himself with a good left to the midsection. Those of us who have seen Benitez fight a number of times in New York in the Garden have not quite seen him this way, so purposeful. So almost grim, determined, and for good reason. What an opportunity. We're a minute 15 into the sixth round. Benitez, after Palomino had come on in the fifth round, again, making the fight. Using the left jab. Taking whatever he can get. See the blue of the Puerto Rican sky in the backdrop. The only open spots are out there in the sun. This is the sixth round. So far, it's all Benitez. Don't forget, this is for the WBC World Welterweight Crown, a scheduled 15 round. Benitez's strategy, of course, just what it's been thus far. Outbox him. Get the 15-round decision. Because Benitez does not really have that much knockout power. Palomino does. Palomino scoring there, but on balance, it's been very much the round of Wilfredo Benitez. That left flicking away. End of round coming up. Start of the seventh round. Palomino is back toward you, the champion, welterweight. And Juan Wilfredo Benitez, the challenger. And after six rounds, Benitez, using that kind of boxing skill, is well ahead. Or seems to be. By the way, a story just came through on the AP wire that unless Larry Holmes defends his WBC heavyweight crown, Palomino just got with a left by April. The WBC against Kenny Norton, which is the key, the WBC will strip him of his title. Benitez scoring well still with the left jab, as you can see. Look how fast it is. And he moved downstairs. Palomino, except for the middle of the fourth round, in the fifth round, has not been able to get to Benitez. Look at that left. At the end of this round, I want to alert our stations along the line. There'll be a station break. This is seventh round action. And for a 20-year-old, for any age, Benitez thus far has been giving a sterling boxing demonstration. Palomino came down with a right that did not score. Benitez quick with the counter punches. We're 2 minutes into round seven. Right there on that break, Palomino did score with a right. Interesting picture right there, silhouetted against the sky. Palomino is missing. Missed twice. Big round for Wilfredo Benitez. We're not that far from the end of this round. Big round for Benitez. We'll be back with more boxing after this word from our local stations.
We're back live. The eighth round just underway here in San Juan, Puerto Rico. The seventh, a big round for young Benitez, but just before the round ended, after we had given the lead to the station break, station idents along the line, Palomino stung Benitez with a shot, sharp, short, right. And Benitez, you could see the glaze in his eyes as he went back to the corner. But still on balance, Benitez, big winner of the seventh round. This is eighth round action. Don't forget, coming up right after this program, this bout, you'll be seeing the inimitable antics of the Harlem Globetrotters, Nashville, Tennessee, in the home of country music. Less than a minute gone in this round. Crowd yelled, the right did not score. Palomino, it seems to me, must start making his move soon. Right there. Benitez flicking in four lefts. He's been a beautiful boxer. Palomino connecting only very occasionally. Palomino trying there with the left uppercut. Benitez protecting very well. Some have said Benitez hasn't had proper leadership, but his father, who's been with him, isn't equipped. He didn't get along with Customato. Jimmy Jacobs, his manager of record, the fight film man, took him up to spend time with Cus. It didn't work. Something's worked, at least up till now, because Benitez really looks sharp. Good right uppercut on the break by Benitez. He's covering well with his gloves. Left in the eighth round. Palomino in there with a left, but Benitez again scoring with his counterpuncher. Again, I emphasize, note the way that head keeps moving, bobbing. It's not an easy target, Benitez. Good right lead, and it cut through Palomino's gloves. Right lead that so many fighters these days are using, that Ali in his prime popularized. Good left. Now moving about the ring, using the 21-foot size. Benitez putting on a fine boxing demonstration, living up to the notices that heralded him when he first came to New York. We're approaching the end of the eighth round, and a good round again for Wilfredo. Call me Wilfred Benitez. Ninth round action. Again, the fight is silhouetted against the sky. Up till this point, a simply fine boxing exhibition by 20-year-old Wilfredo Benitez, who is at 35-0-1 in his record. Palomino, the defending champion, at 27-1-3. Only that draw against Harold Weston to mar the otherwise unblemished record of Benitez. There was a time when Benitez first came to New York to Teddy Brenner, then the matchmaker of the Garden, said this is the best fighter in the world, inch for inch and pound for pound. He never lived up to that. Not after that statement, because he was more style than substance. Right there, a good uppercut by Benitez again. But today, he is living up to it. Palomino, except very occasionally, the middle of the fourth round and the fifth round, getting to Benitez. At least that's this reporter's view. We're a minute into the ninth round. It's a scheduled 15 rounder, of course. The WBC World Welterweight title at stake. Palomino has successfully defended seven times. And look at that. Palomino had scored and hurt Benitez a little. Instead of retreating, Benitez came back, and he is scoring heavily against Palomino. His counterpunching has been just tremendous. And all day, he's been leading too with the left, making the fight. And Palomino looks tired. And it's Palomino who's holding on. Benitez, the master at the moment. And he has been the master from the start of this fight. This crowd is on its feet for their local hero. The crowd. crowd. Just chanting as one, Benitez, Benitez, Benitez. There roars going through this baseball stadium, where incidentally Sam Terce plays its home games in the Winter League, and Frank Robinson is the manager. Ninth round action, and we're going to stay between rounds. Benitez, if anything, coming on even more in this round, and Palomino having the look of a tired fighter with about 20 seconds left in the ninth round. One thing about Palomino, he won't quit. Benitez with a right on the inside, and with another right that snaps Palomino's head. However much he's been chewing up Palomino, that man has been a fine champion, and he hasn't lost yet, not remembering his staying powers and his strength in the late going and his punching power. Davey Boy Green in London cleaned up on Palomino in the early rounds. Right there again, Benitez carrying the fight, a quick combination, then a left to the belly. But against Davey Boy Green, Palomino found strength in the 11th round, knocked him cold. Green was out for 5 minutes. So one is not disposed to count Palomino out. Just the first, the debut of ABC's new International Boxing Championship Series. And we hope this one will bespeak the quality of the amateur and professional bouts to come. Palomino working to the belly and on the inside where he can score, and he just did score. That's the way habitually Palomino has made his fight. Slowing down the opponent, damage to the midsection. Today, thus far, he hasn't been able to do it. As he started to come in, he faced Benitez's left. Benitez has not. Good score by Palomino. But Benitez coming back with counterpunches. Benitez has not found it necessary, other than to dance on his toes steadily, to move that much about the 21-foot ring. A good left by Benitez. It startled Palomino, perhaps more than it hurt him. Palomino now fighting, trying to get inside, trying to use his better power, and having some effectiveness in doing it. This is the 10th round. Benitez with that right lead. Third time he's thrown it, and each time it's scored effectively. 50 seconds left in the 10th round. Fight getting better and better. Benitez scoring with a couple of quick lefts. Jay Edson breaking them up, cautioning Benitez not to hold on. In effect, clinch those fists of Palomino. Locking. Jay Edson, the referee, I repeat, the official, Zach Clayton of Philadelphia, the judge, and Harry Gibbs. Right there, Benitez with a left to the chest and a good right. We are counting down to the end of the round, and Palomino desperate to get at Benitez. We're back for round 11. San Juan, Puerto Rico. And as you have seen, Wilfredo Benitez at age 20 is fighting a fine boxing fight. He is taking his skills and fighting his fight with them. Palomino has not been able to fight his fight. Maybe good right late again by Benitez. Maybe at 29, he has slowed down. He hasn't fought since last May. Maybe the hands are brittle, as Michael Katz of the New York Times suggested in an article in New York Today, maybe. But take nothing away from Benitez. He has fought his fight up till now. The 11th round. point, Benitez, not known as a power puncher, has had, it seems to me, just enough strength in his punches to keep Palomino off him. Certainly that and the left jab, scoring so consistently. Right there, you saw that right of Benitez. Palomino felt it. We're a minute 55 seconds into the 11th round. This was what Benitez wanted. Outbox the opponent, win the decision, and with it to oh, right there! Palomino scoring better than he scored in a number of rounds. But look at Benitez come back. Counterpunching. That's where Benitez has really astonished me today. I have not seen him this effective ever before. Not against a quality opponent like Palomino. We're coming to the end of this round. We'll be away though only 10 seconds and then be back between the rounds. This is the 11th round. Palomino with a good uppercut. We're coming down now to the end of round 11. There's no quitting Palomino, you can be sure of that. The bell for the 12th round. With his punching power, you can't count Carlos out. At Benitez though, as Palomino came out to go right to the belly. Benitez unafraid, totally confident now. This is what he wants, to keep Palomino off him, away, to use that left right there on his toes, a bit of dancing and then dancing away, fighting, as I said, his kind of fight. Palomino loves to get inside, work with the uppercut, move down to the stomach. But he hasn't been able to manufacture it this fight. Not yet. We're almost a minute into round 12. I'm told our satellite video is slightly breaking up. We trust that with good fortune, it will come back to perfection. Palomino on the inside. Benitez now not moving so easily. Perhaps a little bit tired. He has carried this fight. Oh, back with the left. Just when it appeared that Palomino might be slowing him down. Look at that left. In there, in there, in there. Don't forget the right lead. You see, folks, Wilfredo Benitez is a converted southpaw, and he can suddenly turn to southpaw stance. That's why he's so effective with the right lead. And I tell you, as Davey Armstrong on our Olympic team in Montreal proved, converting the southpaw in the middle of a round can confuse an opponent, befuddle him. That's the way Davey beat a Cuban in Havana last January. 2 minutes, 15 seconds into the round. It's round 12. The WBC World Welterweight Championship at stake. A dogged Palomino, but a surprisingly aggressive and sharp Benitez. To the end of the 12th round. There it is. Back live at ringside, 13th round coming up. Benitez against Palomino. I have not seen, at least in the more recent rounds,
Palomino make effective use of the right hand. Knowing how brittle his hands are, I have to wonder if there is either a mild break in that hand, which he has broken once before, or if it is bruised to the point where he is having trouble using it. He just threw it, and then the left missed both times. Just an observation. Notice it's the left he's throwing. He did throw one right. Benitez clearly does not have the movement he had earlier. He's been through 12 rounds, most of which he has carried the fight in. Palomino's left getting in there. Now Benitez with a good left and another. There he threw the right, Palomino did. It did not score. This is 13th round action. Round is half over. Again, our silhouette picture. Crowd here is between 10 and 12,000, I would estimate, closer to 12. Jackie McCoy and Palomino's corner is exhorting Carlos on, telling him that Benitez's legs are no longer so active. And indeed, Benitez is fighting much more flat-footedly in this round. 2 minutes, 15 seconds into the 13th round. Oh, there's a good combination. In fact, two of them scored by Benitez. That stopped Palomino dead in his tracks. And there's Benitez fighting back. But Palomino now clearly, as Benitez fights back, Palomino in this round has been able to deliver blow upon blow to Benitez, who has stopped moving. However, I still have not seen the right effectively used. And the moment this round ends, I'll see what I can get out of Jackie McCoy as to the right hand. Coming up now to the end of the 13th round. We're back. You're looking at Alfredo Benitez coming out of his corner for the start of the 14th round. Right there, Benitez stung, as you could see, Carlos Palomino. Benitez, who turned flat-footed for much of the last round. Be interesting to watch him now. Seems to be picking up in movement again, and he remains unafraid. Palomino only throwing that right in close and not effectively. For the rest, it's the left. There's another good score by Benitez. Taking 13 rounds as a whole, again, the key, Benitez has fought his kind of fight. Just ask Jackie McCoy if anything was wrong with Carlos Palomino's right hand. Jackie, of course, manager and in the corner. He said, I don't think so. Carlos hasn't mentioned anything to that effect. So we'll assume the right hand is sound but ineffective in this fight so far. Look at that. Fourteenth round action. Again with the left as Carlos tries to get in there. Benitez to the left of your screen. Palomino with his back to you. Again, Benitez scoring on the inside rather than Palomino. Notice how quickly Benitez covered up after a wild right left him
for an instant splash open. And again, the counterpunching after Palomino had tried to get to Benitez. Oh, yes. The youngster, 20 years of age, is fighting a clever fight. Now, Palomino, indomitable throughout his career. With Benitez not moving, pinioned against the ropes. Benitez fighting back. Palomino desperate to get in a blow that would put him away. But Benitez again with the counterpunch. Look at Benitez get it in there and Palomino come back. And Palomino is finding this young man a different kettle of fish from the others he's fought as Benitez now carries it back to Palomino, staying with his back to the ropes, using the hand speed, scoring. Look at the crowd. On its feet is one. The 20-year-old Wilfred Benitez. A marvelous round for the last minute and a half of it as Benitez stood flat-footed against the ropes, took the best Palomino could give him, and gave Palomino more. You're looking at Carlos Palomino. Can't tell you how much I respect that man, and Ryan O'Neill, who is so devoted to him. This is a fighter who has always given everything he's got. Never given a bad performance. There's the youngster who has seemed so devil may care, who has not lived up to his notices until today, which was the title of a hit song played by Andy Kirk in the Seven Clouds of Joy back in the 30s. Okay, 15th and final round. This crowd doesn't want to sit down. Gradually they are doing it. Benitez wanting the finish with a flash. Palomino hoping, looking for a knockout. Through the right, the best thrown right into the belly before the subsequent right did not score. Jackie McCoy is screaming, the body, the body, the body. But Carlos has done the best he could to get in there throughout the fight. That's why I have said repeatedly, Benitez has fought his fight and has not allowed Palomino to fight his, as you just saw with Benitez scoring again. And the left keeps flicking out like a piston. This is the 15th and final round. Benitez keeping those gloves up there. Minute 10 into the round. On the inside, Palomino punching upward. Crowd now won't stay down. One by one, row by row, they stand and start that chant. Benitez, Benitez, Benitez. That blow, the right of Benitez, caused more of a reaction than it deserved. It was grazing, but it doesn't matter to the fans here now. This is their man fighting the way they thought he could fight when, as a 17-year-old, he beat Cervantes to become the youngest man ever to win a world title, the junior welterweight title. We only have 50 seconds left to go in this fight. And Palomino can do nothing on the inside. He cannot get in there even. Benitez wound up on the inside, scoring with an uppercut and then keeping that left in Palomino's face. Carlos wildly with the right, trying to get to the belly. 20 seconds left, 18 left, counting down. 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10. It will be a fight to a decision. What Benitez wanted, it is over. We await the decision. Benitez being lifted aloft by his handlers, by his friends. Joy, much like the aftermath of the victory over Antonio Cervantes 3 years ago. Fans getting into the ring, the police effectively keeping them out. Fredo Benitez. In the minds of most here, a clear-cut, even overwhelming decision winner over Carlos Palomino. But we await the official decision. Second, here is the official decision.
De los jueces. El juez Harry Gibbs vota 143-146 Benitez.
One vote for Benitez.
El juez Zach Clayton vota 145-142 Palomino.
Well, Zach Clayton of Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, gave the bout to Palomino. So it was indeed a split decision. I should like to talk to Mr. Clayton about that.
El referee Jay Edson vota 143-148. El nuevo campeón, Wilfredo Benitez.
Jay Edson, the deciding vote, as Gibbs and Jay Edson voted for Benitez, and everybody sees the fight his own way, subjectively. Quite frankly, I thought Benitez, who is the winner, fought his fight, fought it efficiently, made the fight, dominated it, and from watching Jackie McCoy throughout the fight in Palomino's corner, I knew, in fact, that McCoy knew it. Now, we are getting Wilfredo Benitez to our microphone in what little time we have left. We've got a minute. Let's look in that camera, Wilfredo, if we can get him. My congratulations to you on winning the championship, as he waves to his fans. Were you surprised? Were you surprised that they called it a split decision, that one man voted for Palomino?
No. I don't care, but I win. I won the fight, and I don't care about the decision, because they knew that I win the fight. That's why they give it the decision, because he split decision, because he is a great fighter, and they don't want him, you know, to lose them so bad, you know.
Final question. You made the fight exactly the way you planned it, didn't you?
Yeah. For me, I give you the hand because you're a great man. They're talking about you, and I hear about you, and you're a great man. I want you to go every time, be in the ABC, because you're a great man. Well, and thank you very much for the visit. Okay.
All right. Thank you very much. Good luck to you, Wilfredo. May you have a successful championship reign.
I want to say hello to my another country, New York. That's the great.
Once again, the winner is Wilfred Benitez. Yes, Wilfred. He's the new World Boxing Council welterweight champion. And what a great start for our new International Championship Boxing Series here on ABC. Travel arrangements made through, promotional fee paid by...